stopping by and thank you for clicking on this video. In case you are not aware, this is Parenting Essentials from the Vision Guide. And today, I am going to be answering questions and I want you to relax. Let's do this together. Come on. So, today, I have questions that I'll be answering as much as I can. Let's get started. The first question I have with me today says, in episode 4, you mentioned we should not tell children not to cry. Kindly expatiate. It's true. Don't cry. How do I mean? Yes, I said it. Don't tell children don't cry. So, true. Don't tell children not to cry. Because crying for anyone, not even children in this case, is an expression of emotion, is an expression of how we feel within. Not only children cry, even parents, adults, anyone can cry. As much as you want to express the feeling that required tears to run on your eye, then we cry. So, telling children or your child not to cry means you telling your child don't express your feelings, and that for a child is going to hurt more rather than you as a mother giving the solution. So in the situation like this, what can we say as parents? Don't forget, we want to find out what the problem is, and if the problem is not known, solution cannot be given. So you tell your child, how may I help you? Or if you have to mention the word cry, why are you crying? Those are questions that can help your child to relax and explain the reason why he or she is crying or how you can be of help. So, when your child cries, don't say don't cry. Just simply ask, how may I help you? How can I be of help? Or why are you crying? Then you get to find out what the problem is and you will give the solution. Been able to answer that particular question. I'm going to move on to the next question. Question number 2. It says about sneaking out. That seems to be the only solution that I have. How can I handle that? Sneaking out on your children. Yes, I remember I said that we should not sneak out on our children, but this seems to be the only solution for you. How do you handle that? Yes, I know it's a kind of tough situation. You know, when you tell your child you're leaving or your child sees you leaving, your child is going to cry. And you as a mother or father, you don't want your child to cry. So you tend to sneak out every time. Let me let you know that a lot of people have issue of trust from a very younger age. And it's always good for you to let your child trust you. I know it's not easy. Reassure your child. I am going to leave, then I'll come back. At first, it might be a difficult situation. You see your child crying, you might burst into tears when you step out. That's okay, but ensure you are out of the door before you cry. Just give a smile and give the reassurance. Just give a lovely smile to your child and give the word of reassurance. Mommy, we always come back. I'm gonna leave right now, but I'll be back. At the beginning might not be so easy. Just give it a try. Like, first time your child is not gonna cry. Of course your child will cry, but you will come back and tell your child, I told you I will always come back. Then another thing you tell your child, I'm gonna go and come back. With time, your child will get to know that you leaving is not a permanent situation, that you will go and come back. But when you tend to always sneak out, even though your child cannot explain, mommy, I don't trust you, you said you're not leaving, then I just turn back, you sneak out, you're already building a trust issue for your child. So I hope I've been able to answer that question. Just inform your child with a lovely smile, giving a reassurance, and go out. Even if it takes you to cry, make sure you're outside. And when you come back, tell your child, I will always come back. Let it go on. With time, your child will stop crying. Your child will believe that mommy will go and we always come back. Whatever you teach your child or whatever knowledge you pass across to them, they stick to them. So just like children love routine. So it's going to be a routine. Mommy will leave with a smile and she will come back. And that will not be a problem. Just try that and let us know how that goes. Question number 3 says, in telling my child I'll give you something, do this. For example, I'll give you chocolate if you clean up. Is that a form of reinforcement? Like you telling your child, go and wash the dishes or clean up the playroom, I'll give you chocolate, I'll give you candy. Is that a form of reinforcement? It depends. I think I get the sense of this question, because many a times it's not actually reinforcement. It's like you don't know how to pass the message across and you don't know how to teach your child for you to establish a mother-child relationship. Many a time sometimes, you know, parents use this as an escape route. You just go clean up, I'll give you chocolate. Reinforcement is giving a reward for a good behavior. I said it in episode 2 that reinforcement is not going to be a permanent situation. It's what you fed off. It's not a permanent thing. Every time you just say to your child, I'll give you chocolate, go and clean up. I'll give you candy, go and do your work. Without feeding this off, your child will always live on this. You will not be able to give direction to your child. It can be a form of reinforcement at the beginning. If you are trying to establish a behavior, a pattern of behavior, is a method that you use to establish a pattern of behavior. It is not what you as a parent should dwell on. When your child gets the point, then you feed it off. If you have been given reward for every action, then you turn it to 2. When you do something, you get a reward. Slowly you fed it up. If your child is going to follow the instruction all through the day, do whatever you have to do, then you can get a reward at night. Slowly, as your child grows and get the point, you feed off this aspect. It's not really about the chocolate or the candy. It's about your child following the instruction. I hope this explanation is good enough. If not, kindly let us know. Number 4 question, which is going to be the last question today, is I believe we need to command respect from our children as parents. Command the respect from our children. What is wrong with me telling my child, you stay under my roof and you do what I say? First of all, respect should be earned. It is not actually to be commanded as parents. I know we have right on our children and we can tell them what you want them to do. However, before a parent can make the statement, you stay under my roof, you do what I say, I believe that parent is not talking to an infant or a child. It should be maybe a teenager, a youth, a young adult, you know, before you can talk to somebody like that. So this brings me back to the foundation. So that is why we want to do catch them young, teach them right. Because a lot of things can be corrected, can be done, can be fixed from the beginning. If you have been having good relationship with your child from the very beginning, like trying your best to raise your child well, I am not blaming you. I want you to get the point. So for us who have younger ones, and for you parents that are still having grown-ups, they are not teenagers yet or young adults, there is a lot we can do to avoid us getting to the point of making the statements. Do what I said to you because you live under my roof. Because if you have done correction in the past, it won't get to this point. However, if you find yourself in this situation, you don't need to command respect. You earn it from your child. You already in the situation of telling your child, do what I say because you live under my roof. First thing you have to do is to relax. Know that there's an error that needs to be corrected. If you don't acknowledge your problem, solution will be very difficult. So see this as a situation that you need to fix as a parent. So you start rebuilding that relationship between you and your child. Bring back the trust, bring back the love. Let all correction be in love. It is good for you to relax and don't give a comment to everything that child is going to do. Relax and watch. Putting the clothes, that's wrong. Going out, the shoe is not good. Kids at the stage, adolescent, youthful age, they get overwhelmed. Like, oh my God, why is she telling me everything? You relax and do it with love. Not everything you have to complain about, especially what is not going to hurt your child. And let the correction come with love so that your child can trust you. I will not teach you what to say. However, as a person, personally, I feel no parent should make that statement to a child. Just do what I say because you live under my roof. And I've heard of so many cases, you know, in the Western world and things like that. You know, they end up leaving the house as they can't wait to be 18. And some of them will not even wait to be 18. They just want to be out of the house because they've been hearing the statement over and again, you live under my roof. Now they want to live elsewhere. Let's guide our children's heart jealously. So I believe I've been able to answer a few questions today. If you have any question from this discussion today, or you have a burning question in your heart, you can always send us your question anytime and any day at thevisionguide@gmail.com. The email is being displayed on the screen, thevisionguide@gmail.com. Keep sending in your questions and we are here to try our best to explain to you as much as we can. Thank you again for stopping by today. Thank you for watching this video. All our videos are available on our Facebook page, The Vision Guide, and our YouTube channel, the vision guide. They are going to bless you. You're going to be blessed. Trust me and myself. All right. Thank you for staying to the end of this video. My name is Hoye Lion. Don't tell anybody. Hoye is my name for short. Thank you and stay blessed. I'll see you next week. Bye for now.